Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Tawny. And in today's video, I wanted to do a try on and review of a pair of Levi's jeans that are a little bit less common than the typical wedgies or 501s. And those are the 725 high rise boot cut jeans. If you like this video and are interested in seeing more like this, then be sure to subscribe down below and give it a like. But without further ado, let's get into the video. So once again, the pair that I got are the 725 high rise bootcut jeans, and I got them in a size 26 waist and a 30 inch leg length, and in the color dark horse. This style retails for $69.50. However, it's usually on sale. I think I even got it for about $45 with all of the sales that Levi's was doing at the time. And it's composed of 60% cotton, 22% viscose, 16% polyester, and 2% elastane. So it's definitely a mixture of a lot of stretchier, lighter fabrics other than cotton. So it's definitely gonna be a bit more comfortable, definitely stretchier. It's not gonna have that vintage, rugged denim feel like some of the other styles from Levi's. But the back of the jeans still has the very classic Levi's branding with the leather patch up here and also the red leather tab on the pocket. And these are part of Levi's Sculpt line, and they are marketed as being hyper soft, which I would have to agree. They are pretty soft and stretchy, definitely more of a jegging material than a 100% cotton denim feel. It has a high rise zipper fly closure, and the rise on this pair is 10 1/4 inches. So it's definitely not as high as the Ribcage style from Levi's, but it's pretty close. It does hit pretty much at my belly button. It's not really surpassing my belly button too much, but it is a pretty decent high rise cut that I'm happy with. Last week, I actually reviewed a couple of bootcut jeans, but the Ribcage style from Levi's, and I will link that video down below, and I'll kind of compare and contrast the two different styles from that video if you saw it. Basically, I really loved the fit of those jeans on the waist and the butt area. I loved the rise and how it just kept everything in really nicely. However, they were a little bit wide going down the legs, and the flare at the bottom was definitely more of a flare cut jean and not so much a boot cut jean. Those ones open up about 19 1/4 inches, I wanna say, whereas these ones only open up at the bottom 17 1/4 inches. So it's definitely a less wide open pair of jeans. And I will also say that these are pretty tight all through my leg, basically just until my calf area where it does start to open up a little bit more into a flare style. For reference, I am 5'4". I typically wear a size 25, 26, sometimes 27 in denim, depending on the brand and the fit. And these jeans fit absolutely perfectly on my body. I really, really love the way that they fit and the way that they look. And they almost remind me of the type of flare jeans that I would have worn like 15 years ago when I was really little and flare jeans were really popular. This pair, in contrast to the Ribcage style, does come in three different leg lengths. It comes in a 30 inch leg length, 32 inch, and 34 inch leg length, whereas the Ribcage jeans only come in a size 33 inch leg length, which in my opinion is very, very long. It's really going to only work for women who are much taller, unless of course you go out and get it hemmed on your own. The 30 inch leg length on me hits the floor exactly perfectly when I'm not wearing any heels. And then when I'm wearing heels, it's obviously raised up a little bit more. In the try-on portion, I will show you guys how these look with some booties underneath, as well as just some regular platform heels. Overall, these jeans are extremely comfortable. It definitely has to do with all the viscose, polyester, and elastane in the jeans, so I do appreciate how comfortable it is. But I will say, I do think it looks a little bit more flare cut on me than it did on the model on the website. I think when wearing booties, it might look a little bit less flare cut because obviously the boot shaft opens up a little bit, but I would actually consider these a flare cut jean. They definitely do come out on their own, but in a very subtle way. So I think that if you're interested in getting into the flare trend style again, but you don't want a pair that's super wide and obnoxious, then this is an excellent option for you. My only suggestions to Levi's is that I wish that these came in a few more color options. There are only two color options available for this style, and they're both two dark blue washes. They don't have a black. There's no like medium wash or even a lighter wash, which I think would have been nice. And I would appreciate if the high rise were just a little bit higher, closer to the Ribcage. But overall, I do think that these are a very classic looking jean. I don't think that they're necessarily the trendiest pair at the moment, but they are very flattering on, and I do think that they will stand the test of time. But that's all that I have for you guys for this video. If you enjoyed it, once again, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe down below. And I hope to see you in my next video. Bye.